Hi friends, hope you're all doing good. So it's a lockdown in Bangalore. So some of you friends were asking whenever I upload the videos, so what is this equipment and what is that gadget do, how it is helpful and all that. So I thought of showing you, let me take you through desk tour, only my desk, not the whole studio. So let's start with my 8-inch old speaker. This is very good for me. So especially for a low end, this is really really good. But only one problem: if I increase more than 50%, you know, it's already blasting in 35 or 40%. It's already blasting, but if I increase more than 5, it little bit distorts. So it's been 2 years. It's very cool. It's working good. And I have my Yamaha. So this is HS5. This is more of an high-end stuff to judge vocals. I mix on this, and guitar I mix on this. This is such a, you know, wonderful product. It doesn't trouble you too much, and you know, it's been almost 5 years. From 5 years, I just once, you know, I sent it for a servicing. That too, it's because of our mistake, power fluctuation. Apart from that, it's an amazing product. So next, what I have here is, this is 21 inch, you know, 21 inch has been calculated like this, across, you know, it's not the wide. So this is widescreen. So I do a lot of background scores and a lot of, you know, arrangement, music arrangement. I use Logic Pro. What I have here is Hackintosh. So this is very useful, you know, when you have, you can see all your tracks in one screen. You need not to keep scrolling down and that. Plus, I use my clips, you know, for a background score. I simultaneously watch my movie and then again do the thingy. So MIDI-wise, I just removed my other A61 keys MIDI. What I have is Alesis Q49. This cute and very nice. Even if I wanted you know, octave to be moving up and down, I just simply press up and down. It's quite good with the, you know, pitch bend and the modulation wheel and all that. And what we have here is NX Control 2 USB. So it's a Behringer product. So this is to control, it's like a control station, you know. You have a talk back here, plus the big knob for a volume, mute button, dim, then the speaker control. So this input, you know, section, and this is an output section. So I connected two speakers, two pairs of speakers. One is Yamaha HS5, another one is Volt 18. So whenever I want to listen, you know, Volt, I switch to this. Another one is you know, Yamaha. So and headphone. You have two headphone out, and also you have an you know, tape in and out, you know, backside of the thing. So this really good and very 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 helpful. So come, here we go. So here is the colorful deal happening here. So the snake is coming from inside, you know. So it's a 12 channel snake. So we also record drums and stuff like that. So preamp, 8 input, you know, this is a PreSonus audio box, 18 VSL. It works good, superb. So now this is a sidechain. So it goes through the preamp first. This is a beautiful 2 channel preamp, you know, it's a tube preamp, you can see it. So from there, it again sidechain to DBX compressor. So why compressor and preamps? Because first is the quality, to improve the quality of it, you know, clear it, the room noise, whatever you do, whatever you soundproof it, you will have your room noise and stuff. And especially our room is quite bigger, you know, it's also a jam room where we can fit in 20 people. We can also record orchestra and stuff like that. So so it's obviously there's going to be a little bit of room noise. To avoid the room noise, I said, you know, almost 20%, not even 20, 15% of threshold and a little bit of release, and just manage so that you don't get that little bit of hiss noise also, your quality is going to be amazing. So this is the main equipments what we have, and also I have a 4 TB hard disk here, and we rarely use this. This is a Behringer DI. When we if you are recording bass guitar or keyboard and the other thing, this is a crossover. I didn't really not using it really, so this is how it looks. So desk, we made it ourselves, not accurate like a carpenter, you know what he does. We just had an idea and got it done. And I have my piano, digital piano, in case sometime I use that as a MIDI also, in case if I need that feel of playing the piano and stuff. It's all internally connected. So let me take you through application. So I have divided recording and composing. So whenever I compose music, I have my different login. If the boys or my engineers, my interns are recording it, I have my different login for it. So I use mainly a Logic Pro because I started with that. For me, that's the best DAW. So till now I'm enjoying it, but not really worry about. Sometimes I just finish the whole song only with the Logic Pro plugins. Sometimes live takes and things like that. So this is what it is. Looks like this is the place which I spend most of my time. So let me show you a studio tour, in case if you want to comment. So later I'll take you through what we have, what we do. So tomorrow is our live session going on. I'm just doing it with my mobile, it's too boring at home. I just thought of walk into studio and just do something at least, So this is it, guys. So hope to see you again on the next video. Bye bye.
Okay.